groups of believers.
وإن طائفتان من المؤمنين اقتتلوا فأصلحوا بينهما فإن بغت إحداهما على الأخرى فقاتلوا التي تبغي حتى تفيء إلى أمر الله.
And
the Quran says, إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون.
Does Allah order the killing of Mormons?
I'm not, this is a term.
No, he just started the topic. No, he mentioned an ayah.
Ask him, do you believe both groups of believers?
Do you believe both groups of believers?
Answer me.
Allah says in the Quran, they're both the believers. Allah says they're believers.
Listen.
Allah says they're believers.
I do not.
You're not smiling.
Now answer me, please. You mentioned an ayah. You just mentioned a verse. And I'm asking you. Does Allah order the killing of mu'mins? Please say yes or no. I'm not honestly, I'm not takfiri, first of all. Let's establish this. I'm not takfiri, so don't ask me what if they were not. Do they are mu'min or not?
Smile, get a smile in there.
You brought a verse.
Yeah.
And I asked you, does Allah order the killing of mu'mins? You said no.
Yes.
Sah?
Does Allah, yeah, go.
No, agreed?
Yeah.
But in that very verse you mentioned, Allah says, kill them. قاتل الذين تبغي. So what happened there?
Who refused the peace?
Allah.
What happened there? Wait, brother, Allah. Please. Let's take it back.
Okay, finish.
So what went wrong there?
I mean, generally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't allow the killing of Muslims. This is why what I meant by this. All I'm saying is basically the people that say
the Sahaba
alayhim ar-ridwan when murtad, I say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Wallahu waliyuhuma, walaqad afa Allahu anhum, inna Allaha ghafurun alim. All these verses can be found inside the Quran.
Right.
People object, they say, wa Muhammadun lil rasul. And another thing I want to mention is a bit of a topic. Wa idh batala Ibrahim rabbuhu bi kalimatihim fa atammahun. Yeah, this is another off topic. They're trying to prove imama through this, yes or no?
Why are you talking about something important?
Yeah?
You're trying to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
All I'm saying, this the point I'm trying to make is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنْ طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ قَتَتَلُوا وَإِنْ طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ
قَتَتَلُوا.
That if two groups of believers fight, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has classed them as believers, not disbelievers. This is the point I'm making. I don't want to discuss anything else.
Exactly.
Finish the verse.
You can't chop it off.
It's haram.
Let's
take the verse bit by bit, please, brother. You can't just take the one of them and you discard the rest. Abbas, no, please. Abbas, it's not fair.
Two women groups fight each other. Make peace between them. If the one who refused, you have to fight.
That's not my topic. That was my topic.
My topic was regarding the believers. You're refuting this verse because Allah said,
Allah subhanahu says with regards to Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, I've mentioned this before, it wasn't on camera, I thought I mentioned this. فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه
سبحان الله
الله سبحانه وتعالى سيش به الصاحب وزي الصاحب أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله لا تحزن إن الله معنا indeed الله سبحانه وتعالى's help is with me and you.
الله
he didn't say إن الله معي ومعك. Allah's help is with me and with you. He says Allah's help is with us.
صاحب
you see that in the time of موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Are you making speech?
No. I'm the woman in the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, according to different traditions, there was between 300 to 300 sorcerers. They stayed with Musa alayhi salatu wasalam for a limited amount of time. The Quran says, فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ رَبِّ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ.
for a limited amount of time, they stayed in the Qumna Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. They say to Fir'aun, faqdi ma anta qad, do as you like, we are not going to leave this deen. Who is greater, I ask? Are the disciples of Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam greater, or the Sahara in the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam? They spent 23 years in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. They went through persecution, hardship. How is it possible that these individuals, they become murtad as soon as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam leaves this dunya? How is this possible, my brothers? Right. This goes against, it goes against logic. That the Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, this is inside the Quran. The people of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, the sorcerers in that time, they are with him for a limited amount of time and they become believers within an instant. فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ We all I'm trying to prove today is the fada'il of the Sahaba. وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوعًا with regards to Sahaba alayhim
ridwan. Clear.
These are clear cut verses in favor of the Sahaba alayhim ridwan. I ask you, when you ask, if you ask a Jew or a Christian, who are the best people from amongst your religion, they will say the disciples of Musa alayhi salam, of Moses. They will say the disciples of Jesus alayhi salam, peace be upon him. Then we ask the Shia, when we come to the Shia people, we ask them, who are the worst of people? They say the disciples of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How is this possible?
Abbas, yes? Now I have to stop you.
Okay.
You start lying.
No, I'm not lying.
No, you start lying.
Okay, wait.
I'll tell you why. First of all, Abbas.
Okay, wait.
Off camera. Listen to me.
Ready.